Hello dear student, how are you? I hope you are very fine today. Today I will teach you another lesson that was changing narration. Dear student, in my last class I taught you basic of narration. Today I will teach you how you can change direct narration and indirect narration. Okay. Before learning to change direct to indirect, we will review our last class. Okay? Okay, what was our last class? Just preview of the last class. In the last class, we learned what is narration, we learned why narration is used, we learned how many kinds of narration, we learned six basic changes happen in indirect narration, how do these changes happen. Today we will practice and be expert in changing narration from direct to indirect. Okay, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, don't worry. Okay, just six basic changes. This is very important. Six basic changes of narration you should follow always when we will go to change direct narration into indirect narration. What are those six basic changes?
First, reporting verb. According to reported speak,
that means repeating verb will have to be changed. Another, inverted comma will be changed according to reported speech. Pronoun will be changed according to subject and object of reporting verb. Tense, a verb will be corresponding past tense. You know already corresponding past. Last class I discussed about. Okay, now punctuation will be full stop for all time. This is all that I taught you last class, and I hope you have learned and you have practiced again and again. So today we will practice. Look. Look, just look. Wait. Yes. If the reported speech is of assertive, you understand assertive sentence? Then reporting verb will be said or told. Comma will be that. Comma, that means inverted comma. And other changes will be as usual. Six changes. Among these six changes, here we can see three changes. Reporting verb will be said, comma will be that, and other changes. You know other changes? Yes. Pronoun, tense. Okay. Example. Rana said he wrote a poem yesterday. So what will be the indirect? Now try to change. Rana said he wrote a poem yesterday. Reporting verb will be said or told. Here we can write said, and comma will be that, and other changes. So what will be indirect? Look. Yes, Rana said that he had written a poem the previous day. What changes happen here? Said has been used, inverted comma, has gone out, that has been used, and he has been used, he unchanged, because I told you that if the pronoun is third person, that pronoun will be unchanged. And wrote, this is a past form will be past perfect, corresponding past. So it has been had written a poem yesterday, has been changed the previous day. So I think it's not difficult at all if you learned the last lesson. Okay, now
Let's try for another sentence. Shumi said to me, I have finished my lesson. Dear student, try to change this sentence into indirect.
What will be? No. Shumi said to me. Then reputing verb will be changed. Inverted comma will be changed. And pronoun will be changed. Have auxiliary verb, that means verb or tense will be changed.
Okay. Look. Shumi told me that this is the first person pronoun. It will be changed according to subject of the reporting verb. So I will indicate Shumi. Then we have to use she, pronoun of Shumi. She, then have, it will be past, had will be had. She had finished my, another pronoun, my. This is first person, so first person will follow subject, always subject. First person will indicate subject of final, subject of reporting verb. So Shumi's pronoun is she, but here the pronoun is my, I, me, my. So this Shumi will be here, her. You understand? My. So here has been pronoun her. So what is the indirect narration of this sentence? Shumi told me that she had finished her lesson. So dear student, now practice more and you will be expert. Look at this. Salam said to me, I write a letter. What will be indirect narration? Salam told me that I, first person I. This will go through the subject. So, pronoun of Salam, he. So, Salam told me that he, right? This is a present, so it will be past. Wrote a letter. So what will be the indirect? Salam told me that he wrote a letter. Okay, next sentence. He said to me, I wrote a poem. He said to me, I wrote a poem. So what will be the indirect? Again, he said to, you can change this, said to, told. He told me. Then inverted comma will be changed. That, he told me that, I, this is pronoun, it must be changed, I will be changed according to subject, he, so he, and this is verb, wrote, this is past form, so it will be past perfect, and you, this is a second person pronoun, this second person will go to the object of this reporting verb. So what will be indirect of this direct narration? He told me that he had written my poem. You understand? I hope you must understand. Don't worry. Now, if you practice these sentences at home, I hope you must be expert. Okay, so can I go to the another slide? You can take this snap of this slide, or you can repeatedly watch the slide and practice. So we will go to the next kinds of sentence. Okay, this is another exercise. So nice, you have a lot of sentence to practice. No problem. If you practice more, you can play cricket well. At the same time, you can change direct narration into indirect narration. Okay, here Shakib, the best player of the world. Shakib said, oh, this is a mistake. Oh, don't worry. Shakib said, I love crickets. What was with indirect? Dear student, Shakib said that he loved cricket. Okay, no, practice more. To practice, I think you must be expert in changing narration. Okay, now we go to the next. If the reported speech is of interrogative sentence, what will happen? Though I told you in my last class, again I'm telling, yes, reporting verb will be asked or inquired of. And invited comma will be if or WH words. And interrogative will be assertive, and so interrogative sign will be placed on. All these messages was provided to you earlier, but again I have told here for your better understanding. Now let's see the sentence. Oh, another changes will be as usual. Okay. The teacher said to me, do you practice English speaking? This is a direct. So what will be indirect? The putting verb will be asked. Verb comma will be if. And indirect sentence will be assertive. Now, what will happen? Teacher said to me, what will be the teacher? Okay, fine, asked to me. And then, if, yes, very good. Now, look, the changes. The teacher asked me if I practice. Yes, there is a mistake. Practices. No. It will be practiced English speaking. So I hope you will correct this verb, because this is a present for me to be first. Okay? So the teacher asked me if you, that means second person, it will go to the first person. But this you was subjective form, so this me will be subject form I. If I practice this present, so it will be past. I practice English speaking. Okay, let's see another example. Mother said to her son, Why did you waste your time? Here will be you. Okay, it was a mistake, painting mistake. Why did you waste your time yesterday? So what will be the indirect? Look. Mother asked her son, why did you, second person, will go to her son, object of the reporting verb, her son, the pronoun of her son will be he. And he, this is a past tense did, so it will be past perfect. He had wasted time, your time, here will be his time, it is another mistake. So I hope you are now expert, you can correct all the mistakes. Can you? Oh, fine, yes. Then the previous day. Okay, now again, if you can understand how interrogative sentence is changed into indirect. Now let's practice. It is a practice sheet. Fahim said to her sister, will you go to school? Look, this is an interrogative sentence. So Fahim said to her sister, it will be fine. Asked her sister, an inverted comma will be what if. This is WH, no, this is W but not WH. So inverted comma will be if, and subject you, second person, it will follow this object of this repeating of her sister. So the
pronoun of her sister will be she. So, for him, asked her sister, if she will, this will, auxiliary verb it will be past, she would go to school. She would not went. Why? Because we have already used first form of auxiliary verb would. Then, no need to use another past form. In one sentence, only one past form. Remember this basic knowledge. Anyway, sorry. What will be the indirect speech of this sentence? Say to me, do you like to read poetry? Oh, poetry. What will be the indirect question? He asked me again. This is not doubleless question. So yes, no question. He asked me if, then you will go me. So if I like to read poetry, do will be will out will be out, because this is an interrogative sentence. Indirect question will be assertive sentence. In assertive sentence, if the assertive sentence is affirmative, there is no need to use auxiliary verb. So this auxiliary verb will be out. He said to me, where do you live? This is WH question. So what will be the indirect narration? Can you change it? I hope you can. Yeah, I am showing you. He asked me where. This word will be used in place of inverted the comma. He asked me where. Again, these two will be out. He asked me where I live will be past. Where I live. Okay, dear students, I will not change all direct narration into indirect narration. These are for you, for your practice, for your understanding. If you feel problems, then next class I will help you to solve these problems, or you can ask me through messenger, email, or directly calling me. Thank you very much. We will go to the next. If the reported speech is imperative, you know imperative sentence. This is if the reporting verb will be advised, ordered, requested, bade, proposed, told. What? If the reported speech is imperative, then reporting verb will be advised, ordered, requested, bade, proposed, told. When we make this indirect narration, and what change? Inverted comma will be to or not to. Then there is a different things. Inverted comma will be to or not to. If the sentence is negative, not to. There is no that or if, and no change of tense. It is only two things. In reporting verb will be advised, ordered, requested, bade, proposed, told, and comma will be to or not to. No changes of tense. But other changes will be as usual, that means pronoun changes. Okay, so now there is a question. When advised will be used, when order will be used, when request will be used, when bade will be used, when purpose will be used. Okay, don't worry. When the sentence indicate advice, you know advice, and if the sentence indicate order, then repeating verb will work. If there is request, then requested, and if proposal, then proposed. If you cannot understand whether the sentence is advice, whether sentence is order, whether sentence is proposal, then you can use also told. Okay, let's see example. Father said to me, help the poor. This is advice, definitely. This is an advice.
Father said to me, help the poor. So what will be the indirect? Father said, this said will be changed. Use advised. So father advised me. Then the inverted comma will be changed into to. Father advised me to help the poor. Another example. The teacher said, don't waste time. Don't waste time. So this is also advised. This is also advised. So in the notion will be the teacher advised, but this is negative. So I will use not to. The teacher advised me not to waste time. Let's see another example. She said to me, please give me your pen. This is request. This is request, not advised. So she requested me to give. Please is not needed when you use requested. You understand? She requested me to give me first person to the girl subject. She is, so it will be her, like me. She like me to be her. Your pen, second person to the object, so my pen. She requested me to give her my pen. So understand, if the reported speech is imperative, inputting verb will be advised, word or requested, paid, proposed, and inverted comma will be true or not. But here is a question, where is proposed, where is paid, where is true? Okay? Let's see. If the reported speech begins with let us and let me, what happened? They said to me, let us play cricket. Then they proposed to me. Then the reporting verb will be proposed. They said to me, let us play cricket. So this sentence begins with let us. So it will be they proposed to me. Said will be just proposed. They proposed to me. Then to play cricket. This latest will be out. Latest will be out. Remember, latest will be out. Latest will be out. To play cricket. Next. You can also change this derivation into indirect in this way. This is traditional way. But this is very modern way. You can change it. Okay. They proposed to me that. Then you can use that, let us, you can use we should play cricket. So I think it is the best way to change. So you can follow this modern way very easy. They propose to me, then to play cricket. I think if you feel comfortable, you can also use these rules. They propose to me that we should let us, in place of let us, you can use we should play cricket. So understand? Okay. If you practice, you will be clear. Another. He said to me, let me say something. Let me. In this sentence, I told if the reported speech begins with let us and let me. Here the let me. He said to me, let me say something, let me. So what will be in the narration? If, cannot. He requested me. If the sentence begins, let me, let him, let her, then said to is requested. He requested me to let him say something. Just requested. Of course, you can also change this sentence in another way. He requested me that let me. It will be first person will go to the subject. He might say something. You can also change this sentence in this way. Okay, it's your choice which rules you will follow. So I think if you practice at home, you will be clear.
Okay, now
it's for you for practice. The teacher said to me, be attentive to study. The chairman said to the counselor, let us discuss the matter. The chairman, this is later, so proposed his counselor to discuss the matter.
Okay.
At home, you should practice this, okay? Then, if you feel problem, we will solve this, okay? Next, can I go to the next? Can I go? Okay. Let's go. If the reported speech is optative, you know optative? This is optative. Okay, sentence begins with me, that is optative. Imperative will be wished, afraid, inverted comma will be that, sentence will be assertive, and other changes will be same. Look, he said to me, may Allah bless you. He said to me, may Allah bless you. So what will be changes between me will be wished. He wished me that Allah might bless you. Allah has been come first because sentence will be assertive. Allah, the may has been might. This is auxiliary verb, may. So this rule is same. Allah might bless me. Just here is new rule, wished has been used. So practice. The teacher said to us, may it be great in life. The teacher wished us that you, same person related object, we may be great in life. Okay, next sentence for the practice. If the reported speech is exclamatory, how funny! What is exclamatory sentence? Can you remember? Reporting verb will be exclaimed with joy if the sentence is joyful, and reporting verb will be exclaimed with sorrow if the sentence is sorrowful. Inverted comma will be that, sentence will be assertive. Now, let's see the example. The man said to me, how nice you are. How nice you are. So what will be narration? Opening verb will exclaim with joy or sorry. It is joyful or sorrowful. It's a joy, fantastic. It's very joyful. So the man exclaim with joy. Exclaim with joy that this sentence will be assertive. How nice you are. The assertive sentence in the subject will come first. You and I. Then subject verb. In exclaiming sentence, subject verb sits last, but in assertive sentence, subject and verb will come first. So, you is second person, subject will go to the object, means it will be I, and this verb I was very nice. Because how nice you are, this sentence, if you change it assertive, it will be you are very nice. So, I was very nice. Two changes. First, exclaiming sentence will be assertive, and then assertive sentence will be in the declaration. Okay, mother. She said, what a pity it is. What a pity it is. Pity. So it is sorrowful. So I will be she exclaim with sorrow that, again, subject here is last, it will become first. It was a great pity. What has been changed? Great pity. So, okay, now practice at home. Practice at home and feel problem, find problem, and same problem, sharing problem, discuss problem, then all problem will go out. Okay, dear student, now we will go to some exception. There is the exception for good morning, good evening, good afternoon. Repeating verb will be wished. Actually, if good morning, good evening, and good afternoon is in inverted comma in reported speech, then repeating verb will be wished. That example, he said to me, good morning. So So what is indirect? He wished me good morning. Fine. Another, for goodbye, repeating verb will be bed. For goodbye, repeating verb will be bed. Look, the man said to us goodbye. So it will be the man bade us goodbye. Okay, for vocative case, repeating verb will be addressed as, address will be addressed as name of the relation and then is a, another rose. This is vocative case. He said to me, brother, help me. This is vocative. Brother, he is calling my brother. So it will be, he addressed me as brother. He addressed me as brother and requested to help him. More exceptional. For sir, madam, respectfully is written before reporting verb. If sir or madam is in inverted comma. For example, the boy said to me, sir, can you help me? So look here. The boy respectfully asked. Only for sir, here has been in respect. But the boy respectfully asked me if I could help him. Same rules, but for sir, here has been respectful. If subject and verb is absolutely an exclamation sentence. He said, how said? Look at here, there is no subject, no verb. Then what will happen? Exclaim on sorrow that it was very said. So if there is no subject and verb, you have to think it and is as a subject and verb. Okay, that's the end of our today's lesson. I hope if you practice at home, you will be able to change direct narration into indirect narration. And if you can change this sentence narration, and next class, you will be able to change passage narration. That was our main target. In your exam, passage narration will come. So let's be ready for passage narration and practice more at home. And till my next class, thank you and wishing you best of luck. Bye bye.